Several important questions yet unanswered. One is, what is the relationship between our auric field, our subtle emanation, and that state, place of utter stillness, presence, which we know is just a name for something else? And who are you? And what do you do? These two questions are not only relative, they're synonymous. Over these last weeks, there have been several stories told that give us very clear clues as to how we can answer these questions. One story was a story about Elijah's violin. When it came into the possession of the princess and she raised it to her throat and put the bow to the instrument, it seemed to play itself. And then there was the prince who was a slave, and when he put the kingdom back in order and he placed the instrument that he'd found in the forest on the throne in the center of the garden of that kingdom, the instrument played itself and announced and reminded everyone of the name of that kingdom. Let's see what this story, also about an instrument, does to allow us to put it together in our own way. The workings of life in us, the workings of life relative to our chemistry, our emanation, our aura, so that we can answer these questions. Rabbi Abraham was a musician. He came from a long heritage of musicians, and he played a violin that had been in his family for many generations. Rabbi Abraham loved to play. He played at the synagogue. He played during the times of the festivals. He played at weddings. Particularly, he loved to play at the weddings of orphans. He played in the summertime in the streets of the poor, when their windows were open and the melodies could float in and bring a little lightness and happiness to their beings. He particularly loved to play those haunting melodies that had no words. But then, one day, when it came to a great festival time and the snow was heavy on the ground outside, Rabbi Abraham, after a day of communal feasting, went out in the snow, the deep snow, so that he could play to the poor, to lighten the evening of this great festive day. Rabbi Abraham was over 60 years old, and his wife was very concerned. Don't go out in this weather. But this was his custom, this was his ways, and he insisted on going out in the snow, into the village, to play in the streets and bring happiness to that day. The evening passed, and 10 o'clock came and went, and still Rabbi Abraham hadn't returned home. His wife was very concerned, and when midnight came around and he still hadn't come home, she was very, very afraid for him. Then, as the hours went on, she could bear it no longer, so she went to wake up the keeper of the synagogue who lived nearby, and he in turn went to wake the rabbi, and they trudged in the deep snow to see if they could find Rabbi Abraham. They went to the poor part of town, and when they came there and asked in the various houses, "Oh yes, he's been here, he played for us, but it was some while ago," they came back unsuccessful. They were not able to find Rabbi Abraham. But by this time, the morning light was coming up, and even though the keeper of the synagogue was very tired after being woken and being out in his search, it was his duty to go and open up the old synagogue. But to his very great surprise, when he opened the doors, inside, there was Rabbi Abraham playing his violin. And when the keeper of the synagogue said, "What are you doing here? Where have you been?" "Rabbi Abraham, don't interrupt me. Don't interrupt me. I have to learn this melody." And then, after playing it again and again, a melody that the keeper of the synagogue had never heard before, finally, Rabbi Abraham said to him, "Do you want to know what happened to me?" And he related that when he'd finished visiting the houses of the town, he'd maybe had a little too much wine sharing with them, but it was so late and the weather was so bad, he decided that he would take a shortcut through the synagogue grounds. But when he was passing through the grounds, a voice spoke out to him and said, "Rabbi Abraham, son of Ben Cohen, won't you come and pray?" Rabbi Abraham said, "When I heard those words, it was in the voice of Minash, our old cantor who had died many years ago. And though my legs were quivering with fear, I could not but answer the call to prayer. And when I entered the synagogue, the Torah was out of the ark, and there around the ark were many spirits. They looked like cobwebs, and they were praying. I was afraid," said Rabbi Abraham, "and I wanted to hasten from there, but I had